Let us continue with our shortest job first scheduling. The job which is having the minimum burst time is allocated the CPU first. SJF can be either preemptive or non-preemptive. Preemptive means what? The CPU will be taken away from the process forcibly, even if it has not completed the execution. But non-preemptive means what? The processor will not be taken away from the processor unless and until it has completed its own task. There is no force behind taking up the processor. Here we will discuss the preemptive SJF. Preemptive means what? The process will be forcibly asked to release the processor in the middle of the execution. Now here you can see, is what? Here the time is also given. So consider the time also over here. So time is given, that means what? You have to first consider the time. So time is what? 0, 1, 2 and 3. So at time 0, which process has come? At time 0, process P1 has only arrived. Process P1 has arrived, but at time 1. Now look over here, at time 1. Which process has arrived? Process P2 has arrived. That means what? Now your process will be forced to take the CPU, taken away the CPU. Now the chance is given to whom? Process P2. Process P2, now here keep track. How much milliseconds are remaining over here? Only 7. So 1. Now again, at time 2. At time 2, which process has arrived? Process P3 has arrived. Now, while keeping the track of arrival time, also keep the track of the remaining burst time. At time 2, which process has arrived? Process P3 has arrived. But whose burst time is minimum? Process P2's burst time is minimum. So again, who will get the chance to execute? P2 only. And at time 3, which process has arrived? Process P4 has arrived. But the minimum time is with whom? Again, process P2 only. So again, it is going to get the chance. Now it will take the complete time and it will be 5. Why it is going to take the complete time? Because there is no arrival time after 3 milliseconds. So it has completed the execution and it has become 0. Now look at over here, which process is having the minimum time? Process P4 is having minimum time, that is 5, and it is going to release the processor at 10th millisecond. So it has completed the execution. Now remaining P3 and P1. Now whose minimum time is there? P1. So P1 will get the CPU. So it is going to take P1, and how many milliseconds? 7 it is going to take, that is 17. And finally process P3, and it is going to take for how many milliseconds? 9 milliseconds. And now the total is how much? 26. Now the completion time of the individual processes, we'll find out the completion time of process P1 is 17, process P2 is 5, process P3 is 26, process P4 is 10. Now turnaround time, 17 minus, it is turnaround time, arrival time, 17 minus 0, that is 17. Then 5 minus 1, that is 4. Then 26 minus 2, that is 24. And say it is 10 minus 10 minus 3, that is 7. Now waiting time, turnaround time minus burst time. So 9, 0, 15 and 2. Now to find the average waiting time and average turnaround time. So average is what? Average waiting time इक्वल्स टू व्हाट? 9 प्लस 0 प्लस 15 प्लस 2 एंड डिवाइडेड बाय हाउ मच? 4, नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेसेस विच इज इक्वल्स टू 26 डिवाइडेड बाय 4 विच इज इक्वल टू 24.5. एंड नाउ द एवरेज टर्न अराउंड टाइम. एवरेज टर्न अराउंड टाइम इज वॉट? एवरेज टर्न अराउंड टाइम इक्वल्स टू हाउ मच? इट इज 17 प्लस 4 प्लस 24 प्लस 7 डिवाइडेड बाय हाउ मच? वंस अगेन 4, विच इज इक्वल्स टू 52 डिवाइडेड बाय 4 विच इज इक्वल्स टू 46.75. एंड वॉट इज द थ्रूपुट ऑफ द सिस्टम? थ्रूपुट इज वॉट? फाइनल कंप्लीशन टाइम इज वॉट? 26 डिवाइडेड बाय हाउ मच? 4, नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेसेस. दैट इज इट इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? 24.5. Okay, so this is nothing but preemptive scheduling. By looking at the preemptive scheduling, you have to take care of arrival times also. While arrival time you have to take consider, after that you have to consider the burst time also. And you have to keep in mind the minimum burst time process will be allocated the CPU first.